Hello everyone. Today's topic is design of offset link. As one of the topics, we are going to learn something more also. So design of offset link is the one. Design of offset link. Now we have already earlier learned C-frames, how to design C-frames. And this particular say object offset link is also of that same type. So what is, first of all, what is offset link? That let us try to find out. Now we have already learned during the, let's say, Ethereum machines, we have drawn some such mechanism. That time we came across what is called as a link. So as you know, these are different links. Here there are four links here, this is one such link, and so on. Now what happens when these links perform motion? Sometimes it happens that there is a chance of some kind of an obstruction. Suppose this link is performing, let's say, such kind of action during its working. So during its working, when it moves, suppose there is some object here, then there is a chance that it might just get obstructed by that object while its motion is taking place. So what is done is, the link is modified, of course it can be modified in many ways, as you have seen in the case of expansion of link, but sometimes it is modified in such a way that it becomes offset link. Now let me first draw this link to see how it looks. So this link looks like this. Although we have drawn it like this, in actual practice it is something like this. And then there is a hole here. The whole year. Now these are the pin joints, as you know, kinematic pairs, and then this length is represented by this line. Now this is not offset link, this is a normal link. Now because of this kind of an obstruction, what is done is, some material from here is removed and the shape of the link changes to something like this. Something like this. That means here the material is removed. So now it is no longer symmetric. See what happens is, suppose the force you are showing is like this. This is the force acting on the link. Initially the link was straight like this. So whatever was the cross section, the neutral axis of the cross section, the force was passing from the neutral axis of the cross section when it was without getting cut. But now because it is cut, I will just show the cross section here. This is the cross section, and then the neutral axis position is here. Somewhere here is the position of neutral axis. So now you will find that the line of action and neutral axis, there is some distance E. So the force is now not acting along the neutral axis, but it is offset. Now this situation and what we have learned, C-frame, what we have learned last time. This is a C-frame, let's say it has got similar cross-section. This is the position of the neutral axis and the load was acting here. So that time also we saw that there is a sort of a eccentricity that is present here. So this load is not acting along the axis. It is acting at certain distance, which is the eccentric distance, and this P into E is resulting into a moment, which is what we have taken into consideration last time. Now same thing is happening here, although these two figures look totally different, but principally, technically, if you find, they are same. The way load is acting, the way the position of the neutral axis is shown here and here, it is same. One may be horizontal, one may be vertical, that is not important for us. What is important is what kind of stresses are developed. From the design point of view, we are interested in only one thing, what are the kinds of stresses are developed, and accordingly we start the procedure for the design. So you should realize that these two are same. The case is same. The type is same. So now the next thing is, how do we design? How do we design this cross section? So suppose we start exercise. Suppose T is the thickness and let's say B is the width, and I'll write here given. given the load, then the stresses, design stress is given, and E is given, and you are asked to find out. You are asked to find out what? Thickness and B, which is let's say 3 times T. So find out the cross section, that is the exercise. Now do we do, once we know that this is same as this, how do we do is, we start with the stresses. So we write here, stresses acting on, for cross section, you can name it A or whatever, it's not so important. So at a cross section what happens, direct stress FT direct. What is the direct stress acting on this? Direct stress is straight away load upon area. So it is load P upon area B into T. The direct stress, it is of tensile type and it is this much. Then the other is the bending stress. So we write here FT bending. This is equal to M by Z. And is equal to M is P into E, and Z is for this section 1/6 of T and B square. 1/6 of T B square. So from these two we can now say total stress FT total is equal to FT direct plus FT bending. So we are going to add the two. So I write here. So it is equal to P upon BT plus P into E upon 1/6 TB square. This is the total stress. So that means on this section, this is the total stress acting, which is of tensile type. And we are going to equate this with the design stress, which is given. And now from this particular design equation that is formed, we can find out T. And B, because B is in terms of T, so only one unknown, which is T, and the rest everything is known. So you can find out T and B. So you can write here, find T and B, which is equal to 3T. So we have found out the cross section for an offset link, which is like this. And we have also seen why it is like this, what is the reason for a link to be made as offset link. And then we saw that this case is similar to C-frame. Therefore, same principle we have applied, such section is experiencing direct stress and bending stress, and accordingly we have done. Now, this of course, this stress what we are talking about is existing at which place? As you can see, because of eccentricity, it is going to bend like this. So, the outside point, suppose I have point here 1, and this point we call it as 2. So, what we are writing is at 1, because at 2, it is going to be direct stress will be tensile and bending stress will be compressive, so the effect will be nullified, and compressive stress is always much safer. Therefore, we are talking about everything at point 1. Okay, so this is the design of offset link, simple exercise, and based on the case of direct, the part subjected to direct and bending stress. Now next, let's take the next type, design of brackets. Design of brackets. Now let's see what this is. Let me first draw the figure of a bracket. So say this is a support, and then if you see in this direction, just showing the back end. So maybe suppose I see in this direction, view in the direction of D is like this, and what we see is this is a frame or say support. On that support we are fixing this bracket with the help of a base plate. This base plate is fitted at these four points and the bracket is like this, and of course the load is applied like this. The load is applied like this. So now our job is to design this bracket whose cross section is a rectangular, simple rectangular cross section of B by T, and this is the kind of loading that is given. So very common thing, you can see this many places, there is a bracket like this which is fitted to the wall with some bolts. We are going to even later on going to design these bolts, how to design the bolts in such case when the load is applied like this, that also we are going to see. So in which case the entire bracket including the bolting etc, everything we can design. Right now we are talking about only this bracket, the shape is like this. And as you see the B is going on increasing, but what we are interested in is at this place where the moment is going to be maximum, therefore B is what is shown here is the one which is at this place. So now one thing is there, as you go further you will come to know, this problem is not so straightforward, because it is involving principal stresses, and therefore although I am writing it here as a design of brackets, in reality it is not so easy to solve this problem as a design problem and find out the values of T and B. So instead of that, this problem is given in a different way, where T and B are already given to you, P and E also is given to you, and you are asked to find out the stresses that are induced. Okay, so I just write like that. In the given I'll write FT design, and the other things are P, E and T and D. That means as such all the dimensions are there, load, everything is there, and you are asked to find out the stresses, find induced stresses. Find the induced stresses, that is the exercise. So how do we do this? Now, first of course you have to think what kind of stresses are acting on this section. So as you see here, which kind of stresses are acting here? As you see, this is the cross section, this is the direction of load. Now since the direction of load is along the cross section, that means it is creating shear stresses. So one thing is sure, on this section there is going to be shear stress. So I'll write here, the direct stress on section, for section, I'll write here, for the section, direct stress is going to be F shear. Direct stress is going to be F shear, and this stress is how much? So F shear is equal to, this is of course induced stress, so this is equal to load upon area. So phi is the load and the area is V into T. But remember, although this looks same, this is a shear stress this time because the area is parallel to the force. Any other stress that is acting on the same section? We are talking about a section at this place. Maybe I'll show here. We are talking about this place. What is the stress on this section we are talking about? So direct stress is the one which is this much. And you will realize that on this section there is going to be a bending stress, because the section is here, load is applied here, and there is a distance. So P into E. Alright, here P into E becomes a moment that is acting. So the other stress is the bending stress on the same section. So I will write that as F bending. Now this will be how much? We have had here FT bending, and this FT bending will be equal to, this will be equal to M upon Z. So M is moment P into E, and Z is section modulus for this section. So as you can see, neutral axis is like this. So it is 1/6 of the dimension along the neutral axis is 1 time, that is T is 1 time, and the perpendicular dimension B is to be squared. So 1/6 of T into B square, which we have written many times. So we have now seen shear stress induced and then the bending stress. We will not write it into at the moment because there is some other things which are also involved. So this is a shear stress, this is a bending stress, and both these stresses are acting on the same section. And as we have seen earlier, we are not supposed to add them just by numerical addition. So there is a square root equation which implies that there is going to be principal stresses are involved here. So we should write now the equation which is involving principal stresses, which I will write here. So since I write, since the section has shear as well as bending stresses, principal stress will be now coming into picture. So I'll write here FT principal. Principal stress will be equal to, now here I am going to write an equation which is that square root equation which will show us how to combine these two stresses, in what way they are to be combined. So that formula which we have written sometimes back is equal to half of FT plus square root of FT square plus 4 times F shear square. So this is a formula which we are supposed to make use of, where FT we are going to put this particular expression wherever there is FT, and F shear, that place we have to put this equation. So now if you remember, if you see what will happen, suppose I put this equation in place of FT, this equation in place of F shear, and plus also there is a square, and also there is an addition, and also there is a square root, and then multiplied by half. So this equation, if you fully write, it will consist of lot of terms. And what is, suppose it is a design problem, and then what will happen is, the unknown of course will be T, B is in terms of T. So the whole equation, although however complex it is, it will consist of T, it will be in terms of T, which is unknown, the rest everything is known. On this side, FT principle, what is written, that is a place where we are going to write. So I will write here equal to FT design, which is given. So that means here, this entire equation we are going to equate with the given tensile design stress, and then this equation is going to be very very complex because it will consist of all these so many terms. Therefore, it will not be straight away easy to make this as a design problem. We can still do it. How we can do it? Although it is very complex, we are not going to solve it by any quadratic equation or any such thing. All what you will have to do is, you have to put some tentative value of T and find out what is coming on the right side. On the left side it is FT design, which is given, let's say 80 megapascals. So left side is 80, and right side, by putting some tentative value of T, find out what answer comes, and then check whether the left hand side is equal to right hand side. If it is not, it will definitely not in first attempt. If it is not, then accordingly, whichever side is higher, accordingly make some change in T and find out again the value, and again check left hand side equal to right hand side. Still if it is not, then there is a third iteration you go, again you change the value of T. And now, most probably, you will be able to hit at the correct value and get the answer for T and then B. That is the way it can be designed, as one of the ways. Or, of course, the computer way, which is not possible for us. So, we can do it by iteration, by trial and error. But then it is very, very tedious and very complex work. So, I am just making this problem as a problem of just checking the stresses. So, in which case, this expression, which is this, which will have T and B, since all the things are known, this value is already there with you. Similarly, this value is already there with you. So you have this value, you have this value. So put these values, so everything will be available, and then now I am going to call it as FT induced. So when you put all the dimensions and get the values of stresses as per this equation, the value of stress that will come, principal stress, which is the induced stress, and only what we will do is, we will check whether this is less than the given design stress or not, which is this one. If it is less, it is safe in tensile principal stresses. There is one more stress there, which is F shear maximum. That means, see, as we have already discussed earlier, what this means is, instead of saying there is tensile stress and shear stress, we say there is only tensile stress which is of a different size, which is obtained by combining FT and F shear. So we say only principal stress is acting, no shear stress is acting, but that principal stress is this, which is obtained by combination. Similarly, we can also say, we should also say, we must also say that it is experiencing only shear stress, no other stresses, no tensile stresses, and this shear stress is equal to how much? So that is my formula, half of this part. So again, same thing, this is the one which is induced stress, F shear induced, which should be less than F shear design. If it is so, then it is safe in shear also, it is safe in principal tensile, principal shear also, and as a result, whatever dimensions are given, they are safe. Okay, so this way the design of bracket of this section we can do. Now, what is the next thing? The next thing is, if there are different cases, they have different types. That means if this cross section, instead of like this, if it is of some other type, what will you do? Of course, the very simple thing is, you do it the same way, only what will change is Z. So suppose, instead of rectangular section, what section was given right now was this. Instead of that, let's say there is an I section. If this section is I section, this is an I section, and then all the other things are given to you. Accordingly, what you will have to do is, the area, this area was for this B into T. You have to find out what is the area here and take that area here. Then similarly, you have to find out Z for this section, and that Z you have to take here. And then accordingly, you can go ahead. Okay. So, for this section, you will have to find out area and Z. Put it here. Which I think you can do because we already know how to solve this. So, if it is given as, let's say this is T, this is also T, and suppose this is 8T full is 8T, and then this is say 6T. So that is the dimension. If it is given, then you can write like this. So this was second. The thing to be seen here is, I am saying this you can do, this is already done, this also you can do. What I am going to show is,